The Oratory Foundation, no stranger to the Now Morning Show, just had an absolutely incredible composition, Caribbean Icons. So excited because joining us in studio this morning are some of the youngsters that you're seeing on your screen, and also none other than Deborah Jean-Baptiste-Samuel, founder of the Oratory Foundation. Good morning, Deborah.
A very hearty good morning to you. Thank you for having me on.
It's a pleasure to have you back with us. This is so exciting. And we can't wait to see, of course, our younger icons coming onto the set. But before we get to that, let's talk about the Oratory Foundation and these competitions.
Yes, the Oratory Foundation continues in this work. It is fantastic and fascinating, mm-hmm. if I can describe it like that, because I have the opportunity to work with children from as young as age 7. I start at age 7, and these children come in and we work poetry writing, poetry performance, and they grow. It is a creative pool. It mm-hmm. is a lab. It is a whole gym. Aerobics in language, because we're going to be stretching the language, enjoying the poetry, and the children enjoy the performance. And it puts them on the right footing. They are, then have the foundation for school. Mm-hmm. It is a language arts program that is active. Vocabulary building. They have the confidence, the creative writing. By the time they write SCA, oh, they're on top of the moon. But it is fantastic because they start at 8-7 yeah. and they perform. These competitions are part of it. I am aiming mm-hmm. to bring out all that is marvelous in them and make it manifest. So these competitions do precisely that. And they have French influence in Trinidad. They have music makers. They have Celebrate in Tobago. We had world changers. We had music makers right on TTT yep. some years ago. And now it's Caribbean Icons. And what they had to do for this competition, they had to select a Caribbean icon, do the research, and then we had to create the poems and then performance. And the performance was staged. It was videotaped mm-hmm. and then played before a judge. There are 20 children in this class. I only brought 3 for you today. only 3.
We saw some of them on screen. Now, one of the things that's so incredible, as you mentioned with Caribbean Icons, you shared a list with me of the children.
Yes.
And it's wonderful to see who they selected. We have Beryl McDiburney, Mia Motley, yes. Letitia Wright, Usain Bolt, Brian Lara. So we yes. see from sport to beauty
yes,
competitions and so on.
That's right. And from the other Caribbean countries. The 3 today are from Trinidad. Mm-hmm. Yes. And we've had Louise Bennett. We've had Mia Motley. We've had Usain Bolt. So is Jamaica and Barbados. Letitia Wright is Shuri from Wakanda Forever. Mm-hmm. And she's from Guyana. Mm-hmm. So we have Caribbean representation. And the students are all the better for it, because you don't learn this at school per se. This is additional extracurricular excitement.
It definitely is. And talking about excitement, I think it's time to bring our
yes.
first icon
So on. We have 3 to share with you today. I'm sharing the beauty of my students with the country. And we have Kevanni Ferguson. He presents Sir Ulrich Cross, quite a hero. So, Sir Ulrich Cross, come, Kevanni. Yes, and this is Sir Ulrich Cross, and he'll salute you in a minute.
Okay.
Go ahead, Kevanni.
The only black airman in the squadron, yet selected for the elite Pathfinder force. With precision bombing, flying at 50 feet, served 25,000 feet. What a boss. He earned the title of the Black Hornet, being an exceptional navigator, completing 80 bombings over Europe, fighting for Britain against Hitler.
Good boy. At that point, you clap. Well done.
Excellent.
Yes, Kevanni, thank you. And we also want to share, go ahead. We also want to share Kayleigh Cleghorn as she presents yes. Ella Andel, another Caribbean icon. Come, Kayleigh. This is Ella Andel. Bring down the power of love. Go ahead, Kayleigh.
One thing is certain, and 2 things for sure. She's determined to spread her music throughout the world, clearing a pathway for those who sing Orisha-influenced calypso. With medicine on her mind, but music in her soul, she answered her ancestors' calling for this story to be told. A singer, songwriter, and a descendant of kings and queens, and true to her African identity, with over 40 years in the music industry, she's now known as the Queen of Chantels, Chantel Supreme, and the High Priestess of African Caribbean music. A Caribbean songbird who has also graced the international stage with a resounding, sensational voice and secret chords that can pierce your heart and color your soul with a buttery range of pitch and tone.
Yes.
Excellent.
Bring down the power.
Bring down the power. Definitely bringing down the power on set this morning.
And we have Ariele Applewhite as Miss Universe, Janelle Penny, Commission. Oh. Go ahead, Penny.
The competition was stiff in the majestic capital of Santo Domingo. Unknowing to me, the horn of history was about to blow. For women of color did not seem to shine in such a competition so epic, but I became the first woman of color to cup the Miss Photogenic. As the cute doll, all 70 contestants were now beginning to realize that this competition was different. History was about to materialize. Then I heard, the first runner-up is Miss Austria. Miss Trinidad and Tobago is Miss Universe. Congratulations, Janelle. A bit unexpectedly, my emotions raced. Thankful thoughts placed, I squealed softly.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
So those are three of the students from a class of 20. And they all did quite well.
So I have to ask, because I mean, yes, we've just seen the children come on absolutely amazing.
Yes.
And are going to be imprinted on all of our minds for years to come. How long does it take for preparation for something like this, Deborah?
The module is 10 weeks.
Okay.
The module is 10 weeks, and this is the Oratorian module. They start preliminary, then advanced, and then Oratorian. There's where the competitions get exciting. Mm-hmm. They do the Shakespeare competition, French influence competition. We had a competition just on birds. A child had to select a bird, mm-hmm, and come in costume and talk about all the characteristics of birds. And we had world changers. Two hair were in the world changers competition. Ariele was Helen Keller.
Oh, nice.
And she pretended to be blind for mm-hmm the entire performance. It was awesome. And Kayleigh Cleghorn was Harriet Tubman, mm-hmm, who led the slaves up north into freedom in the Underground Railroad. So these children have a vast wealth of knowledge, and they can go competition to competition to competition and emerged all the better for it.
Now let's talk about that emergence, because one of the things that we spoke about offset is the fact that yes, children may start with the foundation,
yes,
but it goes into adulthood.
Yes, they grow. Mm-hmm. They stay with me. I love them. They love me. The children who start off at age 7, mm-hmm, in 10 years, these children here will be doing Shakespeare, mm-hmm, because that is the trend. They go with me through secondary school. Mm-hmm. The youngest here is 8, Ella Andel. Kayleigh Cleghorn is 8. Kevanni Ferguson, Sir Oric Cross, he's 9. Mm-hmm. And Miss Janelle Penny Commission, she's 11. So that Ariele Applewhite started at age 7, mm-hmm, and here she is now at age 11. So she's going to secondary school, and she's with me. Competitions will continue, but the module expands. At secondary level, they do debating and public speaking in addition to the poetry performance. Mm-hmm. So they will be versatile. And then, in 10 years, these very ones are going to be doing the Shakespeare. My Shakespeare cast, and we just did Shakespeare's 12th Night. When I say just did, the 19th of March, mm-hmm, we did that for the schools, Form 5.
Okay.
They're writing that for exam at CSEC. So this is how they grow into it. You talk about emergence. They will then be doing the Shakespeare plays as they grow. They have the discipline, but discipline, I always say, is more important than talent. So as long as they have that discipline, the talent is going to come. They're going to learn the lines. They're going to have to deliver the line. Discipline to come here this morning.
Yes.
You have to get up at ungodly hours to do very godly things.
The discipline, yes, no. You...
That discipline, is, and it goes into schoolwork. So that they know, no parent here. Have to do homework. They know they have to do their homework, plus my oratory work.
You see, there you go. We see proud mommies and daddies here with us this morning as well. Now, we also have our young icons mic'd. So let's start with Kayleigh as the youngest. Kayleigh, tell me something. Why did you choose Ella Ando?
I love her powerful
Orisha. Just hold the mic up a little bit.
Go I love ahead. Her powerful Orisha chants.
And did you enjoy preparing to be Ella Ando?
Yes.
Wonderful. All right, so let's go across to Miss Universe. Miss Universe, why did you choose to be Penny?
I chose to be Penny because she was the first black woman to win Miss Universe, and she was from the Caribbean. Also, she was from Trinidad and Tobago.
Yes, and you definitely have quite a resemblance to Penny as well. And let's hand the mic over to Sir Ulrich Cross. Let me salute you. Good morning.
Good morning.
Why did you choose to be Sir Ulrich Cross?
Because he's my hero.
He's your hero? Do you think one day you may grow up to be like him?
Yes.
Ah, excellent.
You're going to fight him with a little big one.
He is going to become a pilot.
Okay. Wonderful. Well, I'll tell you what. First of all, Deborah, thank you so much for being with us this morning, and thank you for the investment in our future, so important. Sir Cross, Ella Andel, and Miss Universe, thank you also for being with us this morning. We appreciate all of you, and we look forward to seeing you do many great things. Have an excellent, excellent day.
Thank you so much for having us. Thank you. All right.
Hold on a second. This is the Now Morning Show. Stay tuned. There's more coming up after this break. Your birthdays.